Now we are discussing the topic which is addressing. In the computer network, there are various addresses which are present by which we communicate with each other. So if we talk about the broader area, then there are four types of addresses which are present into the computer network. So there are four types of addresses. The first one we are having is the physical address. The second we are having is the logical address. Third we are having is the port address, and fourth we are having is the specific address. These are the four addresses which are most popular in the computer network. But from where these addresses come from? These addresses are taken from the TCP/IP model. So if I talk about this TCP/IP model, then we know that there are four layers in the TCP/IP model. The top layer we are having is the application layer. Then the next layer we are having is the transport layer. Next we are having is the network layer, or also called the internet layer. And the first layer in the TCP/IP model is the host to network layer. So this is our TCP/IP model, which contain the four layers. Now talking about these layers, on these layers we are having different addresses. So if we talk about the first address, which is the physical address, that is taken from the host to network layer. So first of all, we are discussing about the physical address. So talking about the physical address, well, it is also named with the station address, MAC address, or the link address. We know that on our system we are having the LAN card, and that LAN card provides us the internet connectivity. Now on that LAN card there is a address written physically. We can read it physically. That's why it is called the physical address. There are multiple names like station, MAC, link. So all the names are same. The majorly it is called the physical address. So here it present a host network layer of the TCP/IP model. That means this physical address is present on the host network layer of TCP/IP model. So this is the address which is present at the host network layer, and it is the address of a node which is defined by the LAN or WAN. Address of node. Node means the system. It is the address of a system which is given by the LAN card or maybe the WAN. So whenever on your system there is a LAN card installed, on that whatever the address is written, that is your physical address. Now talking about this physical address, it is included in frame used by the data link layer also. We know that in the OSI model, there is a layer which is called data link layer. At that layer, which is responsible for the framing, means it generates the frame. In that particular frame, we use this address, which is the physical address. Now we are taking the example of this physical address. So if we talk about the example of the physical address, then there is a representation of physical address like this 07, then there is a colon which is provided, then maybe 01, then again colon, then 02, again colon, then 01, then again colon, then 2C, then colon, then 48. So this is the format in which the physical address is provided. Now here every particular block is of 1 byte. So if I talk about 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 and 1. So every block is of 1 byte. If I add them 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 and plus 1. So that is the total 6 bytes. So if I say that this is of 6 byte of address. Now we know that every 6 byte is equal to the 8 bits. So we can say that it is 6 into 8, that is equal to 48. So this is the 48 bit of the address, or we can say it is of 6 byte of address. So physical address is of 48 bit. Now we are discussing the next address, which is the logical address. So if we talk about the logical address, that is present at the network layer of TCP/IP model. As the name signifies, logical, so it is basically used for the logical communication. There are different names of logical address. The most popular name we are having is the IP address. So if we talk about the IPv4 address, IPv6 address, all those addresses which we are finding on our system, just like 192.168.1.11, those addresses are nothing but the IP address or the logical addresses. Well, it is the logical because it is, you cannot read anywhere. This address is not like the physical address. It is like a logical. Now it is created, but it is very much important as compared to the physical address. So we can say that it is independent upon the physical network. Just like the physical address is only focusing on the physical network, means what are the hubs, what are the switches, bridges, or the systems, logical address is not focusing on those different devices. Here it is working on the complete communication, and throughout the network, the logical address will be unique. There will be no system which will be having the same IP address or the logical address. So we can say that it provides the universal addressing system. Universal addressing system means no two IP will be having the same address. That means if a network is there, in that network, two systems will not be having the same IP addresses. Now, talking about the logical address or the IP address, it is present at the network layer of TCP/IP model. So now we are taking the example of an IP address. So if I take an example, we know that this is very much familiar to us, 192.168.17.11. So such type of address we have seen into our system. This is nothing but the logical address or the IP address. Now here four blocks are there, each block is of 1 byte. So here we can say that 1 plus 1 plus 1, that means it is equal to 4 byte. And if I multiply 4 with 8, that is nothing but the 32 bits of the address. So this IP address or the logical address is of 32 bits. So now we are discussing the next address, which is the port address. So now talking about the port address, in the TCP/IP model, this address is at the transport layer. So we can say that the port address is present at the transport layer of TCP/IP model. Well, if we talk about the port address, well, we know that in the system there are different ports. We are not talking about the ports which are USB port or the printer port, no. There are inside the system the ports available, just like if I am sending an email. For the email, there is a SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. So that port open and mail is sent. Whenever we are accessing a web page, there we are having a port which is HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So that particular port open and then our web page is transferred. So similar way, if I am sending the file to another system, the FTP is a protocol which is file transfer protocol, and for that there is a specific ports. So there on every system there are specific ports which work for the different tasks. Now that port are having their own addresses, which is called the port address. Just like for sending the email, SMTP port is there. Then for other tasks like web browsing, HTTP port is there. So their addresses are there. And if we talk about the port address, they are of 16 bit of length. So now we are taking one example of the port address. So if we see the example, just like port number 753, this is one example. So this way we are having the multiple ports with their numbers, and if certain port is there, we can work upon that specific port. Now we are discussing our next address, which is the specific address. So if we talk about the specific address, then on the TCP/IP model, on application layer, we are having the specific address. So we can say that the specific address is present at the application layer of TCP/IP model. Now, if we talk about this specific address, this is more user-friendly address. If we are working on the internet, we are not going to type the IP address, the logical address, 192.168.1.11. No, never. We are not going to type a physical address or the port address. We are usually type the addresses which are more familiar to us, like google.com, facebook.com. So what are these addresses which are for the communication purpose? These addresses are nothing but the specific address, because we can learn easily. That's why these are the user-friendly addresses. So if I talk about the example of the specific address, then there we are having the URLs. URL is nothing but the uniform resource locator. Any of the address which we are typing on our browser, that is the URL, just like any website, maybe the Facebook, Google. So these websites are nothing but the URL, just like if we take the example of a website, which is www.ankitvarma.co.in. So such type of websites are the example of URL. Then we are also having the example of email. So any of the email what we are sending, that is also the example of the specific address. So there we have learned that there are four types of addresses. The host network layer of TCP/IP model provide the physical address. Well, talking about physical address, that address is printed on the LAN card. It is also called MAC address, station address, link address. Then we are having the next address, which is the logical address. It is present at the network layer of TCP/IP model. Logical address is also called the IP address. IPv4 and IPv6 addresses, they are the logical addresses. They are universal, means on a complete network, there will be no two systems which will be having the same IP. All will be having the unique IP addresses. Just like 192.168.1.1, this is the address which is the logical address. Then we are having the next address, which is the port address, which is present at the transport layer of TCP/IP model. Now for different tasks, we are having the different ports. Just like for mailing, we are having SMTP. So they are having the addresses which is called the port address. Then at the last, we are having the specific address, which is present at the application layer of TCP/IP model. This is the user-friendly address. So we remember, just like any website or any email. So that is all about the addressing.